Thank you. How's it going, Toronto? Well, I met Mark Howard in 2005. We were about to make a record. And when you're making a record, you have to find a producer. And finding producers, like finding a girlfriend or a mom and you've never met before, but you gotta make things work. And Robbie Beaker from the Tragically Hip said, you should work with, I'm gonna do my best Robbie Beaker. You should work with Mark Howard. We call him Fudge. And I said, why do you call him Fudge? He said, because he eats chocolate all the time. So we were like, well, that's as ringing an endorsement as we could ever possibly need for a producer. So we called Mark up and he came to Montreal and we had a great time. And then we went to Australia because I convinced our record label that the only place that we could possibly make a record was in Australia. It were different times. That shit doesn't happen anymore all that often. So we went to Australia and Mark set up this beautiful studio in an old church house just outside of a town called Byron Bay, more known for its beaches and beautiful sand and water than it is for rock and roll studios. And I showed up there and he said, all right, play me what you got. What kind of record are we making? I'm like, well, shit, the only thing is I haven't written any songs just today. So he didn't panic, but he set me to work right away. And the band hadn't arrived yet. I was there early on with my friend Matt Mays, who came down with me to help me work slash surf slash drink coffee and beer. And Mark set me to work every morning. He's like, don't go anywhere until you've written something. So this was one of the first songs that was written in a panic in Australia at the behest of Mark. Another day breaks and the last one's gone. You dig deep just to carry on. It's paid out, but don't feel gone. So you slip out the back and you're moving on. Yeah! Well, I can never figure out how to make a case that it's going down too far from grace. She wants to know, can I replace this type of insanity? Says you're the bitch, you know when you get that fast. Put it in the past, put it in the past. This is a race and I hope you don't last. You're on a bridge, you know when you get that fast. So the pressure of this will break to dawn. You can build a house, you can't build a home. And it's a fool who believes love is red and gold. And no guarantees that you won't get stoned. Well, I'm a fool who believes love is red and gold. And no guarantees that I won't get stoned. Says no bridge, no way to get the facts. Put it in the past, put it in the past. This is a race and I hope you come. You're on a bridge, you know where to get that fast. I don't know where it leads, oh no, all I know. Said I don't wanna breathe, this chemical breeze, no more. So another day breaks and the last one's gone. So you slip out the back and you're moving on. Says you're the bridge, you know where to get.
Support that you all are giving us. So thank you very much.
you love me. I want you love me.
why I'm mad. I need to hear this. I can only hear the front of the house. I was going to do this song earlier when we did rehearsal today. I said, I can't follow this song. It's quite a surprise. I was surprised when Lenny Kravitz did this song. I was even more surprised when Kelly Clarkson did it on the National and the Country Music Awards. Became a big hit for her. So we now have Maya Davies. Just pick her out, and literally she's gonna blow your socks off. Is she here? Maya! 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 The lady with four names. Maya, Maya. Oh, there she is. Oh! She's surprised. Okay, I gotta lead the band.
American. We don't get to hang out very often, and it's great to be around all these people tonight. We're all everybody's friends, and nobody sees each other. Thank you, Mark Power, for bringing us all together. I have to talk about our next artist, and this, I just have to say, this story has been approved by Sarah McLachlan. It's about 1994, and we were all at the Much Music Video Awards. Remember when that used to go on? And we went to the after party, and well, there was quite a bit of drinking, and we thought, wouldn't it be fun to have like piggyback fights in the middle of this park? And it was the odds, all of them, straight up, four of them all on top of each other's shoulders, versus me and Sarah McLachlan. I put Sarah on my shoulders, and we were all laughing, and it was fun and giggling. And then the odds got kind of serious about the game. And I got a little freaked out because there was four of them and me and Sarah. So I made her run for it with Sarah on my shoulders, right for the front door, running with her on my shoulders. I opened the door and went running right through the front door of the bar. And I felt a lot lighter after that. And I thought, oh my God, I just killed Sarah McLachlan. I fell to my knees, ladies and gentlemen, on the sidewalk in Queen Street. I didn't even look back. I crawled on my hands and knees, opened up the taxi door, got in and left, because I thought I was a murderer at that point. I can't go on enough about how fantastic this next artist is. I'm just going to give you the chance to tell her how much you love her. Ladies and gentlemen, Sarah McLachlan!
Hey, good evening, everyone. It's so nice to be here. I had the pleasure of meeting Mark Howard 1990. We were living in New Orleans. I was making my second record with Pierre Marchand, and we were the poor Canadian cousins. We got to come down and work in Dan Lanois's studio up in the attic. And Mark was in and out of there working with Dan Lanois. And he was only a few years older than me, but he was an arrogant little shit. Knowing everything, I have to say, he was always really nice to me and always had the time for me. So I'm really happy to be here tonight to support him. And this next song is, kind of reminds me of him, so this is for Mark.
Vampires roar. You stretch your rest away.
Oh, I love the depressing stuff. The sadder, the darker the song, the more happy it makes me. I don't know what that says about me. Anyway, this is a song about redemption and forgiveness.
Thank you all for coming out. Thank you for your time, your donation, and mostly your love to this cause. Great, great love and thanks to our friend Mark Power, of course. Mark Power! Take that love that you shared tonight and spread it everywhere you go, folks. This is our finale coming up.